Hardware trackpads and joysticks allow the user to perform simple movements and more complex gestures to create musical changes. The XY pad device provides the same ability within Renoise and Redux, where using its pad changes the X and Y output values simultaneously. This allows two effect parameters to be controlled in a freeform manner. And, as usual, automations can be recorded by using the right mouse button. The two top buttons swap between the settings for the X and Y axes, which includes all of the parameters below except for auto reset. Dest sets the destination track or sampler effects chain, the chosen effect, and the parameter. Min and max set the minimum and maximum values to be used from the range of the destination parameter. By default, the range is 0 to 100%, but this will change to match the parameter type. Note that it's possible to reverse the output mapping by making the min greater than the max. The scaling option changes how the output value will be mapped across its range. And normally this is applied in a linear fashion, but you can also select from two exponential and two logarithmic scales. When using the pad with auto reset enabled, releasing the mouse button will cause the point to snap back to the values specified here, much like an auto-centering joystick. Once you've finalised the parameters, you can hide them all by clicking the small arrow button here, leaving just the pad. And clicking it again will bring them back. The X and Y axis values for the point on the pad are available as destinations for other meta devices, meaning this device can function in a similar fashion to the mapping devices. However, this is not the focus of the XY pad. It's really about enabling and capturing live user performance.